Hey guys, Chris with Retro Crypt, back for another video stream. To me, it's still spooky season, so recently a bunch of games got added to the Game Boy Nintendo Switch Online. So there's a bunch of games that got added. Blaster Master, Enemy Below, Kirby, Tilt and Tumble, a couple of Zelda games, as you can see. Pokemon, which, you know, I've never been into Pokemon, really. I might check it out just to see what it's like. Quest for Camelot. But this is what I was interested in the most, because anybody that knows me knows that I love Castlevania. It's one of my favorite franchises. Top three for sure. And I never got a chance to play this game, so that's what I'm about to do. Let's give it a try. So, game slot, standard mode. Let's go with standard mode, because this is a tale of a young girl's struggle to single-handedly prove Transylvania, a place ruled by madness and despair, with the light of hope. Alright. Let me read a little bit about this game, because I know there was some So right away we got a cool map screen. I know there was some controversy, I guess if you could call it controversy, about this game. So I know it's, let's see, it's the third title released for Game Boy. Game was conceived as a prequel to all other games in the Castlevania series, however, it later became recognized as non-canon. So, the story follows Sonia Belmont, a vampire hunter, battling the first incarnation of Count Dracula. So, it's non-canon. And I don't really care about stuff like that. It's a Castlevania game. It looks cool. Bloody Tears right off the bat. Or, I should say, a variation of Bloody Tears. Sheet. As with any other Game Boy game, the controls are extremely stiff and janky. So you could walk as you can duck walk, I guess you could call it. It's crazy that the controls are this stiff, because with Operation C, the Contra game, it's nowhere near this stiff. It's actually kind of fluid. Even for a Game Boy game, it is. So yeah, as I mentioned before, to me it's still spooky season. To me, it doesn't really start to become Christmas until December. Let's see. I really want to change the controls here. If there's any wall meat anywhere. I mean, you can mitigate the stiffness of the controls if you're just a step ahead. that's hard to do when it's, you know, if it's your first time playing the game. How do you die from falling down there? That's one thing that always irked me about games. It's like, So I'm going to climb down that rope, and the bottom is going to be about 10 feet. You know, I mean, she would probably get hurt, but she wouldn't die. That's an extremely cheap death they're trying to throw at you. That's very cheap. Oh, nice. At least you don't continue from the beginning. See, I was so excited to play this, and now I'm just like, why was I excited? Down, hit. Duck down, hit. Thank you. Nah. A little too late. She's kind of got a nice butt. Fireball whip. It's one thing I love about these Game Boy games. There's like a pretty cool fireball whip that you get. Trying to clear out my old alerts on here. Don't mind me. Alright. Think I'm ready to play now. Oop. Exterminate. I feel like that's a death pit. So let's go this way. Maybe not. One up right out in the open. I'll take it. Alright, guy. See, I spoke too soon. I was gonna say, I feel like we're actually getting somewhere now. Oh. Oh. Definitely spoke too soon. Getting hearts, but there's no sub-weapons at all. Thank you. Nice. It's back there. One thing about these Game Boy games is that they're consistently inconsistent. Like, if it was that an NES game, that 1-up wouldn't be there again. I'm not complaining. What the fuck? It's just more of an observation than anything. Oh my gosh. I felt like I was actually doing pretty good for a second. I feel like these games weren't as strictly tested as actual NES games. Again, not a complaint. More of an observation than anything. Sometimes it works out in your favor, and sometimes it doesn't, like that. Holy cow. I have so many games that I bought and I have to still complete, and I'm not doing myself any favors by starting a new game. But at least this was free. It's obviously a lot worse when you when you buy 50 games and you don't complete any of them. To keep that in mind, I really just want to play this for, I don't know, like a half hour or something, and then get back into some of the purchase games that I have, so this way I can start chipping away at those. I feel like I should have stopped up there, but oh well. I feel like a boss battle is coming. Thank you. How are you supposed to avoid that? Am I supposed to... I was gonna say, I don't think that was the right way. It's cool that they, added in some branching paths. It's pretty ambitious for a Game Boy game. Nice. This is still the first stage. Jesus Christ. Another trap. Yep. Let's save. Oh no, it doesn't even matter. Yeah, I just wanted to see if that was the death pit. I had assumed. I really can't believe that this is still the first level. Yeah, I'm not going down there. I always feel like I'm not going to make these jumps. Updated. Updated whip. It's not all the way. It's one thing that I could say that this game got right, or these Game Boy games got right, is the fireball whip. That would have been really helpful in the console Castlevanias. The Classicvanias, if you want to call it that. The linear side-scrolling Castlevanias. Not another freaking door. Am I going around in a circle? Am I just not taking the right direction? So I gotta admit, the song is getting kind of repetitive. Come on. Can't believe it. An actual boss? How are you gonna swoop down on me like that? His energy is not going down at all. Do you have to hit him with the actual whip and not the fireballs? Because that would be a pain in the ass. This is a situation. Wasn't able to get any whip upgrades. It's a friggin' his energy's not going down at all. I'm gonna have to look this up really quick because this is kind of crazy. Did I miss a weapon or something? Let's see. boss battle. Says he could whip it. Yeah, outside the castle, axe. I wonder if you actually need the axe. Guess not. You just gotta not get hit. Uh-oh, I lost a viewer. Follow the pattern, man. Just follow the pattern. Whoop, got me. See, look at that. Why does... Oh, croissant? Alright, so that was level one. I want to keep playing, but you know me. I gotta keep going. I got other games to play, so I'm gonna post this up on YouTube and then start my other game real quick, and then I'll continue with this tomorrow. If you tuned in on Twitch, thank you so much. My socials are up there as always, youtube.com/@retrocrypt, Instagram retrochris82, Twitch, where you're seeing me now, retrocrypt82. So thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video.